Hello, Vital Sign. Today we're going to look at domination polynomials. First, let's recap dominating sets. A dominating set D in a graph G is a set of vertices such that all vertices not in set D are adjacent to at least one vertex in set D. In other words, the closed neighborhood of the dominating set D equals the vertex set of the graph. The size of the smallest dominating set in a graph G is known as the domination number of G, which is written as gamma of G. Moving on, the domination polynomial of a graph G is defined to be the polynomial whose coefficient lowercase d of gk on the k degree term is the number of dominating sets of size k in that graph. In other words, the domination polynomial is the sum from the domination number of the graph to n, the number of vertices in the graph, of lowercase d of gk times x to the k. Note that we could also define it to be the same sum except from 0 to n, but all the terms where our summation index is less than gamma of g would be 0. Because there are zero dominating sets in G of size smaller than the domination number of G. So it's acceptable to define it our first way, starting from gamma of G. Now, in order to find the domination polynomial of a graph, we need to first find the number of dominating sets of sizes gamma of G all the way through n, the number of vertices in the graph, giving us the coefficients in our polynomial. Now let's see three examples of domination polynomials, starting with this graph G. Since G has four vertices and domination number 2, we'll be searching for the number of dominating sets of sizes 2 through 4. What are the dominating sets of size 2 in G? Feel free to pause the video and find them yourself. There are six dominating sets of size 2 in this graph. AB, AC, AD, BC, BD, and CD. That means that the coefficient on the degree 2 term in our domination polynomial will be 6. What are the dominating sets of size 3 in this graph? Again, feel free to pause and find them yourself. They are ABC, BCD, CDA, and DAB. Since there are four of them, the coefficient on the degree 3 term in our domination polynomial will be 4. Finally, there's a single dominating set of size 4 in our graph, ABCD, meaning that the coefficient on the degree 4 term in our domination polynomial will be 1. Now that we have our coefficients to plug into the domination polynomial, we know the domination polynomial of G is 6x squared plus 4x cubed plus x to the fourth. As our next example, let's find the domination polynomial of graph F, which has 5 vertices and domination number 1. To do that, we'll need the number of dominating sets of sizes 1 through 5. There's only one dominating set of size 1 in this graph, A. So the coefficient on the 1 degree term in our polynomial will be 1. There are 4 dominating sets of size 2 in this graph. AB, AC, AD, and AE. So the coefficient on the 2 degree term in our polynomial will be 4. There are 6 dominating sets of size 3 in this graph. ABC, ABD, ABE, ACD, ACE, and ADE. That means the coefficient on the term of degree 3 will be 6. There are 5 dominating sets of size 4 in this graph. They are EBCD, BCDA, EBDA, EBCA, and ECDA. This means that the coefficient on the degree 4 term in our polynomial will be 5. Finally, there's only one dominating set of size 5 in this graph, A, B, C, D, E, meaning that the coefficient on the 5 degree term in our polynomial will be 1. Using these values, this is our domination polynomial. There's an interesting, almost binomial pattern to these coefficients because our graph is a star graph. I encourage you to think about where this pattern comes from and to find the general form of the domination polynomial of a star graph with any number of vertices, and then post it in the comments. Moving on, I'd like to point out a general property of domination polynomials that was demonstrated in our example. First, notice that the domination number was 1, and the number of vertices in our graph was 5, and that the coefficients on every term with degree 1 through 5 was non-zero. This demonstrates the general property that in the domination polynomial of a graph G, the coefficient on the kth degree term, little d of gk, equals 0 if and only if k is less than the domination number of G, or k is greater than the number of vertices in G. Every term with degree in between domination number and number of vertices in the graph has a non-zero coefficient. This property of domination polynomials comes from a property of dominating sets in graphs, which is that if you have a dominating set of vertices S and a set of vertices T, which contains S as a subset, then T is also a dominating set in that graph. Note that for graphs with at least one vertex, a consequence of this property of domination polynomials is that there are no constant terms. Note that as we cover more properties in this video, we'll only be considering graphs with at least one vertex. As our final example, after which we'll dive into some deeper properties, let's find the domination polynomial of graph M. M is a path graph with 4 vertices and domination number 2. How many dominating sets of size 2 are there in this graph? Feel free to pause and find them yourself. There are 4 dominating sets of size 2 in this graph, so little d of M 2 equals 4. How many dominating sets of size 3 are there in M? Again, feel free to pause and find them yourself. There are 4 dominating sets of size 3 in this graph, so little d of M 3 equals 4. Finally, there's 1 dominating set of size 4 in this graph, so little d of M 4 equals 1. That means this is our domination polynomial. Let's move on to interesting properties of domination polynomials. We've already covered 2 properties of domination polynomials, the first being that the coefficient on the k degree term in the domination polynomial of a graph G is equal to 0 if and only if k is greater than the number of vertices in G or less than the domination number of G. The second property we looked at is a consequence of the first and states that there are no constant terms in the domination polynomial of any graph with at least one vertex. Now let's take a look at 5 additional properties. Also deriving from the first property, the domination polynomial of any graph G must be a strictly increasing function, as the coefficients on all of its non-zero terms are positive, and there's always at least one non-zero term for any graph. The fourth property of domination polynomials is this. Let G be a graph and H be a subgraph of G. Then the degree of the domination polynomial of G is greater than or equal to the degree of the domination polynomial of H. This is because the degree of the domination polynomial of any graph is the number of vertices in that graph, as that's the size of the largest dominating set in that graph. If H is a subgraph of G, it has at most as many vertices as G, meaning that its domination polynomial has degree at most equal to the degree of the domination polynomial of G. The fifth property is that 0 is a root of the domination polynomial of any graph, and more specifically, it occurs with multiplicity equal to the domination number of that graph. This property is a consequence of our second property, because since there are no constant terms in a graph with at least one vertex, By inputting 0 for x in our polynomial, we will get 0 in return. Also, since the smallest degree term in our polynomial with non-zero coefficient has degree equal to the domination number of g, we can factor out x to the domination number of g from all terms, leaving us with this alternate representation of the domination polynomial, clearly showing that the root 0 occurs with multiplicity equal to the domination number of g. The sixth property is that if a graph g contains m components, g sub 1, g sub 2, and so on up to g sub m, then the domination polynomial of g is the product of the domination polynomials of each component of g. To see why, let's consider the case where g has two components, g sub 1 and g sub 2, and where we have a dominating set D with k vertices. A dominating set in this graph must contain vertices in both components. As if set D was entirely in a single connected component, the vertices in the other component would not be adjacent to any vertex in D. Also, the set of vertices in D that are in each connected component must be a dominating set in that connected component. Essentially, a dominating set in this graph is the union of a dominating set D sub 1 in G sub 1 with a dominating set D sub 2 in G sub 2. This allows us to reframe the question of counting the number of dominating sets of size k in G as counting the number of unordered pairs of dominating sets D sub 1 in G sub 1 and D sub 2 in G sub 2, whose size is summed to k. For each dominating set of some size I in G sub 1, there are as many of these pairs as there are dominating sets of size k minus I in G sub 2. That means the total number of these pairs of dominating sets in G sub 1 and G sub 2, whose sizes sum to k, is the following sum. That number will be our total number of dominating sets of size k in our graph. This number also happens to be the coefficient on the kth degree term in the product of the domination polynomials of g sub 1 and g sub 2. I encourage you to think about why this is on your own. To extend our property for graphs with more than two components, let's use induction. As our base case, we know that for m equals 2, the domination polynomial of a graph with m components is the product of the domination polynomials of that graph's components. Next, let's assume this property holds for any graph with some number k components. We want to show that it follows that this property also holds for any graph with k plus 1 components. We can consider any graph with k plus 1 components as the disjoint union of subgraphs g prime sub 1 and g prime sub 2, where g prime sub 1 is a graph formed by the disjoint union of k of the k plus 1 components in our original graph, and g prime sub 2 is simply the other component of the k plus 1 components in our original graph. Although g prime sub 1 is not a connected component, as when we were dealing with just two connected components in a graph, the same argument we applied then can be applied now. Again, a dominating set D of size k in this graph must contain vertices in both g prime sub 1 and g prime sub 2, because vertices in g prime sub 1 do not connect to vertices in g prime sub 2. Also, the set of vertices in D that are in G prime sub 1 and in G prime sub 2 must be a dominating set in their respective subgraph. This means that a dominating set in this graph is the union of a dominating set D sub 1 in G prime sub 1 with a dominating set D sub 2 in G prime sub 2, just like it was for our M equals 2 case. And once more, we can reframe the question of counting the number of dominating sets of size k in G as counting the number of unordered pairs of dominating sets d sub 1 and g prime sub 1, and d sub 2 and g prime sub 2, whose sizes sum to k. And as for our base case, that number is exactly the coefficient on the kth degree term in the product of the domination polynomials of g prime sub 1 and g prime sub 2. But what is the domination polynomial of g prime sub 1? It must be the product of the domination polynomials of each of the k components that make up g prime sub 1. So that means the domination polynomial of our graph with k plus 1 components is indeed the product of the domination polynomials of each of its components. By induction, this proves that our property holds for graphs with any number of components. To finish the video, let's do a quick recap of all the properties we covered. The coefficients of all terms with degree at least equal to the domination number and at most equal to the number of vertices are non-zero. For graphs with at least one vertex, there are no constant terms in the domination polynomial. The domination polynomial of a graph with at least one vertex is strictly increasing. If H is a subgraph of G, then the degree of the domination polynomial of H is at most the degree of the domination polynomial of G. 0 is a root of the graph's domination polynomial, with multiplicity equal to the domination number of that graph. If G is a graph with m components, then the domination polynomial of G is the product of the domination polynomials of each of its components. That's it for this video. In future videos, we'll take a deeper look at domination polynomials, including analyzing their roots, and thinking about what information about the graph we can glean from the domination polynomial. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, like, share, and comment if you liked the video. Have a great day.